Get over here!
Oh!
What is happening here?
Oh, what is happening, good sir, is one of the greatest games to ever come out for the Nintendo GameCube. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm the Green Scorpion, and here with...
the Comic Foil.
And welcome to the first episode of Let's Play Donkey Kong Jungle Beat. For those of you who are my patrons, a while ago I actually foreshadowed this, but to those of you who have not gotten any word about this, how surprised are you?
This one has been a long time coming, actually.
For us, anyway, because the thing is, like, I personally absolutely adore this game. It's one of my favorite games from my childhood.
Me too,
It's one of the greatest games of the GameCube, in my opinion. One of the best looking.
On the GameCubes, yeah.
Oh my god, yes.
That fur shading, man.
Absolutely. And yeah, so we decided to go ahead and let's play this one, because it is a favorite of ours. And overall, it's just a fun game. It's just a real blast to play this.
There's nothing quite like it.
There really isn't. Now, before we go anywhere, first of all, obviously, the Banana Kingdom's the first level, but we're gonna go here first.
Okay.
Because I'm going to turn this all the way up.
Oh yeah, because, if you're talking a lot while playing this game, your talking tends to...
be picked up by the freaking sensor. I'm not even clapping and it's still picking it up, so we're gonna have to, it's just something I'm gonna have to get used to.
Yeah, this is, you're not gonna be able to, you're gonna have a little bit of trouble playing this normally because of all the equipment around and stuff.
Exactly.
We're trying not to overpower the mic.
We're not trying to overpower the mic with the constant drums that are gonna be going on. And at the same time, the fact that we're trying to project our voices in order to try to drown out the drums is also going to be picked up by the claps.
Oh man, I didn't think about that.
Oh, this is going to be fun. Banana Kingdom, everyone, let's go.
For those of you who don't know what Donkey Kong Jungle Beat is, this is going to be an interesting experience for you.
Oh, it's a great game. So, okay, now, we're just going to go ahead and get in on this. I'm just going to check something real quick, actually.
Secrets? Oh.
Yeah, no secrets here. Okay, so the trick is basically get as many beats as you can. And
right now you have 20 up there.
Yes.
So it's a very arcadey kind of game. Donkey Kong Jungle Beat is a mix of a rhythm game and a platformer. So he is playing right now with the DK Bongo controller on the GameCube. It is literally a set of bongo drums that kind of look like barrels. So there are two big buttons, the left bongo and the right bongo, and also a clap sensor, so any loud sounds get picked up as Oscar clapping. If he wants to go right, he has to tap the right drum. If he wants to go left, he has to tap the left drum.
There we go.
And what is it, jump? Both at the same time?
Jump is both at the same time.
And then there's jumping off walls, there's catching those little monkey guys. But the whole thing, it's combo-based. You want to try and get a lot of bananas and a lot of beats by pretty much keeping a single stunt going. Getting as many bananas, pretty much as much as you can do without touching the ground, is going to multiply the amount of beats that you get. And at the end of three stages, you get a score based on the total number of beats collected. If you get hit, you lose beats. And that's it in a nutshell.
Pretty much.
I'm also taking it upon myself to be the more explanatory of the two of us, because this game does take concentration.
It really does.
And it takes rhythm.
I'm gonna try and,
So you're just gonna let all these guys...
Yes, I'm gonna try and let all these guys... Okay, I do need silence here because it is a little bit, There we go!
Wow. That was a great Shoryuken.
Yeah, that's the trick with those things. It's really weird. Okay, so I'm gonna try and, Let me see if I can get a combo here.
You wanna try and kill all of them at once.
Yeah.
So, try and, you know, kind of let them all get on Donkey Kong, which is very brave of him to do.
Yes. Okay. This is gonna be tough.
There you go.
There we go. Okay. Now, is there something over here? Ah!
This is Donkey Kong. There's always something past the ending flag.
Absolutely. And...
that was the juiciest banana. Like, that's not how bananas work. If you bite into a banana, juice doesn't shoot out. It's not a juice-based fruit.
Hey, game logic. Okay, that wasn't the best, but okay.
You got the slopes, sliding down the slopes. This is just...
like, this is a high-octane game, especially when you get towards the end. Okay, I need to... oh, no!
Oh, you missed a bunch of flowers or something.
Yeah, those flowers actually give you more beads if you get them all. And, okay, well...
can you get... okay, you did it.
At the very least, I got those.
Alright. Now, I know there's, like, a... there's, like, bronze, silver, gold, and platinum medals.
Yes.
So I don't know how much it is you need at the end, like, 1,200?
I think it's 1,200 for the platinum medal, which we're gonna go for specifically because, of course, this game has multiple endings and a secret at the end if you get them all. So we're gonna go for those.
Wasn't this game, like, partially made by Sega?
I don't remember.
No, I'm imagining that. I'm thinking of F-Zero GX.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, they came out around the same time.
Okay. Now, if I remember correctly, yes.
Little clapping monkey. He's giving you kudos.
Yep. Yeah, these are the only time these monkeys actually appear in the franchise, isn't it?
Well, this game really scared me when I first read about it in Nintendo Power, when I was first seeing images and stuff, because... everything besides Donkey Kong himself, every character in this is completely foreign. I mean, they're not so much characters as like different cultures and stuff, but so I mean, Donkey Kong was the NES monster, and then Rareware made the Donkey Kong Country series and Donkey Kong 64, and kind of reinvigorated and brought a lot of what we know to Donkey Kong. Like Diddy Kong and the entire Kong family and the Animal Buddies and the Kremlings.
Yeah, I do remember that.
But this game was basically the first Donkey Kong game to come out after Rare was bought out by Microsoft. So after it was clear that Rare wasn't going to be making any more Donkey Kong games. And it was just a really uncertain time for Donkey Kong. Like, we didn't know what this meant for him.
I'm trying to...
yeah. I don't see gummies everywhere. The crowd's cheering for you.
Got it!
Nice.
The thing is, though, I missed something rather important, and that's right over there. Now I'm gonna try and do this.
Okay, so you made a gummy thing here?
There it is. Yeah, the thing is, like, I wanted to get on that while I was on the, floaty whatever thing. Oh, jeez. Oh, yeah, those things hurt. Those things actually hurt you.
You didn't take a lot of damage, though.
Yeah, nah. Although, I don't know if I'm going to be able to hit 1,200. The thing is, ironically, the first level in this game, the Banana Kingdom, is the hardest to get the Platinum on because of the fact that...
there's just less opportunities.
Exactly.
So, like, looking at this game, you got, like, all these little monkeys and stuff, and I'm... you know, I'm in, like, 2004, whenever this game was coming out, looking at it and being like, that's not Diddy Kong.
Yeah, no.
You don't understand,
it was just Donkey Kong, and that was it.
The Donkey Kong Country games are basically the first video games I ever played. That, like, I owned, that I ever, like, played a lot. They're very...
so seeing this, like, was like, oh, shoot, like, change.
Yeah,
so much change.
Change is bad. And I knew all the characters' names. I had the player's guide for... Donkey Kong Country 1, 2, and 3, and Donkey Kong 64, I still have them.
Oof.
Even Donkey Kong himself just looks really different in this.
Yeah, but it's a really good model. And by the way, here's one of my favorite elements of this game. The freaking Kong battles.
The Punch-Out clone. Well, I wouldn't call it a clone. Punch-Out aim like this.
Yeah, this boss is honestly stupid easy, but it's still enjoyable in my opinion because, like, again, it's something different for the Donkey Kong series, and I think it works.
And it's like it's basically a tutorial because you're gonna have to do this sort of boss fight a couple times. There aren't any more opportunities to get beats that are there.
No, there isn't. So I'm not gonna get the platinum.
Okay. That's okay, you can still show this guy who's boss.
There we go.
Gotta give him the hook, donkey! Don't let him get in your head!
I'm gonna finish this guy in style.
Alright. You're just doing all these tiny jabs. Why are you playing with him?
Ah, I tried to get the uppercut counter, but whatever.
I didn't even know there was an uppercut counter.
Yeah, did you see the counter I did before, like, when he was winding up, I hit him in the stomach and then did an uppercut that made him spiral?
Oh, yeah.
You can do that at a certain point. And every one of the Kong battles you can do that in.
10,000, or 1,000 points, though, on the first try is pretty good.
The thing is, like, I played this game to death when I was a kid,
yeah.
So I do know, like, I pretty much kind of know the ins and outs of how to get the beats and how to efficiently go through each level to get as many beats as possible.
Okay.
Even so, like,
I saw you knew where to go for some of the secrets and
exactly.
stuff.
Exactly. Like, that would tell you, like, yeah, like, I can get, like, all the beats in one go. No, because, again, like, I'm out of practice, first of all. Second of all, the Banana Kingdom just doesn't have that many opportunities to get beats. So you gotta be, like, perfect everywhere, so... And doing that while commentating, where the clap sensor can tell, pick up your commentary, is hard to do.
Well, I'm thinking you're probably gonna go back... We'll have to go back to levels Let's Play.
That's pretty much what we're going to do. We're actually going to go ahead and get all of the crests in this game, because when you do... A secret area unlocks that can lead you to the true ending of this game.
Okay.
Yeah, this game actually has, like, two endings, I suppose you could say. Like, I would say multiple endings, but really there's only two,
That's kind of a Donkey Kong tradition, though. Since Donkey Kong Country 2, there was always an additional final boss.
Yeah, exactly. It's basically like you get the creme coins in DK Country 2, and you open up the secret area. This is no different. You get all the crests, and you go to the secret area that has four more levels and a whole nother final boss and everything. So, yeah.
But for now, that was the Banana Kingdom.
Yeah, and we unlocked three more kingdoms, the Orange, Watermelon, and Apple. I think Donkey Kong suddenly got a hankering for a lot of fruit.
Yeah, it's all the...
Yeah. If this wasn't any indication, every single kingdom and level in this game is named after fruit.
He's eaten too many bananas. See, he needs to branch out now.
How long has he had that banana hoard?
Oh, since like 1991.
Don't you think those bananas would have gone bad by now?
No bananas are bad to Donkey Kong. They're always appealing. Did that pick up on your clap sensor?
We're back, ladies and gentlemen. We're freaking back.
Oscar, it's me with fruit. It's gonna be too easy.
You're gonna make me suffer through this playthrough, aren't you?
Yeah.
Thank you guys for joining us for the first episode of Let's Play Donkey Kong Jungle Beat. I'm the Green Scorpion.
I'm the Comic Foil.
And I'm just gonna get this one out of the way right now. The beginning of the episode, Comic Foil's gonna say, "Orange, you glad you saw us?" Yada yada.
Aw, man. Gonna have to think of something better now.
Really? Do you ever? Actually, no, your puns are rather clever. Also, Skype sound, thank you.
Yep.
I don't know if I'm looking forward to this. I'm looking forward to the game, not looking forward to your puns.